Hey guys, I'm back again. So I made the cookies. I'm a little bit earlier. They turned out great. The kids have already had one. They approve. And so James and I are trying to do our best to not eat a lot of sweets right now. So I packaged them up and we are actually going to give them to some special people at church tomorrow. Some people that serve in our church, like the kids. People that teach them in junior church and people that run our sound and do our music. So we package those up to give those to some people just to thank them for their service. And so that is what we're going to do with our leftover cookies. So now, tomorrow we are going to come home after church and eat. And we typically eat with James's family and get together, but tomorrow everybody's kind of busy, just has a lot going on. So we're gonna come home and eat lunch. And I thought I would share this, another simple recipe. Again, it's something my mom used to cook all the time, and we make it all the time during the fall, during the winter, because it's just, you throw it all in the crock pot, let it cook all day. Kids like it. It can be heated up well, and so we're gonna make some taco soup. Not many ingredients, very reasonable, especially if you're a college student. This is a great, great recipe for you, and it lasts several days. And so, so I have got just 1 pound of ground beef in the skillet right now, browning. And while I'm letting that brown, I've got my crock pot heating up. I just have it on high right now just to kind of get it hot. I'm gonna kind of let this cook on low till we probably go to bed, and then I'll probably kick it down to either warm or maybe even turn it off because it will be hot. Let it kind of slowly cool through the night, and then when we get back up in the morning, I'll turn it back on low so it can cook during church and be ready for when we get home, because you kind of want all of these ingredients, you want the flavors to kind of cook at a slow pace so they all can kind of mix well. So like I said, 1 pound of ground beef. If you decide that you want to make this for if you're having a family get together, you want to take this to a Christmas party like we talked earlier, just double all the ingredients, and it's a really good thing for people to munch on. You can use corn chips with it, tortilla chips. You can even, like I said, if you reheat it up, you can actually put it in like flour tortillas, corn tortillas, kind of as a burrito. So it kind of, you can eat it as soup first off, and then if you want to make burritos with the rest of it, with your leftovers later, you can. And tomorrow, James and I, we're trying to do good on fried food, so we typically take corn tortillas, corn tortilla, divide it in fourths, and we put it in our air fryer, lay it out in our basket for our air fryer, put it in, and turn it on high heat, and we let those crisp up, and those are actually our tortilla chips. And we get, for those of you, if I'm a nurse, so I educate patients all day long, so get ready for it. Those of you that are trying to watch carbs, or if you're just if you're diabetic and trying to watch your carb intake, Walmart, Kroger, that's about the places that we go. They have got the flour tortillas that are net carb, 4 grams, and they are delicious. They taste just like normal flour tortillas. And they've also got some mini ones that are zero. So you can make street tacos with those. You know, I mean, you can do whatever. And they're flour tortillas, but they have zero net carbs. They also just put out some new ones that I just bought at the store the other day that are tomato basil, and they are delicious. So there's just a little side note on tortillas. That's how we kind of make our chips. And that's what we have on the side with these. And you can dip them in cheese dip, and that's what we're going to do. We're going to have a side of cheese dip tomorrow with this. So my meat is almost browned. So I'm just making a one serving kind of for us, because it's just me, James, and the kids. And so while that is browning in your crock pot, I have already rinsed one can of sweet corn. I rinse all of my vegetables just to kind of get that metal taste off the water and all of that. So I drain all of my vegetables and wash them really good. So there's one can of corn. And then you're gonna also do one can of Rotel. You can, if you like a little heat, you can add the hot kind. We typically just do the mild because I don't really like hot stuff that much. I like a little spice, but not much. And so you can put that in there and mix it up. And then, so my meat is pretty well done because it'll continue to cook in here. So I'm adding one can of pinto beans to my meat. And then I've also got one package of taco seasoning. And I just kind of put that in there with my meat to get it going and so the meat kind of has some flavor on it. Stir that around. And you know, I think the last time I made it, I had like some leftover scrambled sausage and I put it in there too. And it was so good. It just adds a little bit of different flavor. And it's, you know, of course, sausage has got some of those spices in it. And so it's really good too to add in if you have ever have extra sausage. So I've got my meat, beans, taco seasoning mix. So I'm gonna dump that in here as well. And my mom did not do this. She would add in a little bit of water because, you know, with your taco seasoning, I think it calls for like 1 cup of water to be mixed. Oh, 2/3 a cup of water per packet of taco seasoning. I do add a little bit of water in here to, of course, give it some liquid. Now, some people, kind of depends. You may like your taco soup a little thicker, and since you don't want a lot of juice in there, but some people do like it really juicy. I'm just gonna kind of do it somewhere in between, but I do add a little bit of water. And then my mom did not do this part, but I do this really anything that I make in the crock pot that's got tomatoes in it, like my chili, things of that sort. I of course use tomato juice. So I do put a little bit of tomato juice in this just to give it a little more flavor. And kind of mix all of that up in there. And this is really for us, for me, James, and the kids, this is gonna be probably just enough for us to eat on tomorrow for one meal. We might have a little bit left over, but like I said, this does keep well if you do want to eat on it for a couple of days. We do okay with leftovers. We typically eat it the next day and that's about it. We don't really do much. If it's any longer than that, it gets shoved to the back of the refrigerator and then I have to end up cleaning out my refrigerator. So we typically eat on leftovers for a day or so and that's about it. So I don't know if you can really tell the consistency, but it's thicker. It's kind of the consistency of chili. And I'm just gonna let this cook. This will be enough for two really probably decent sized bowls for, or bowl for he and I. And then of course the kids don't really eat all that much. And so we should have a little bit left over. But that is it. That's it. And so I'll let that cook. And like I said, I've got it on high right now. I think I'll probably go ahead and kick it down to low because it's gonna cook for a good while. So, taco soup, one can of corn, one can of pinto beans, one can of Rotel, 1 pound of ground beef that you're gonna scramble up, One packet of taco seasoning, a little bit of water, a little bit of tomato juice, just kind of however you want your consistency. And as this starts to cook and heat, I will taste it and see if it needs anything. Occasionally you can add a little bit more taco seasoning, a little bit of garlic salt. You know, you can just kind of add as it starts to thicken and those vegetables kind of start to cook down. Super easy, super good, and like I said, good for leftovers. And so I recorded this video tonight, so it probably won't be on until tomorrow. You'll be watching this on Sunday. But I hope that y'all have a good Saturday night and Sunday morning. Go to church, get rejuvenated for the week. You know, we're coming up on Christmas, and so really just, again, like I had said on some previous videos, you know, just remembering, getting back to the reason of what all of this is about. You know, I've been out and about kind of finishing up a little bit of shopping and grocery shopping, and people are just frantic, y'all. They're just, they're frantic. They're not happy. They're just, I see it so much sadness, and it's just not what it's about. And so, you know, I would encourage you this week to check on those around you, speak life into them, speak positivity into them. You know, like I said, I'm a nurse and I talk to patients every day on the phone, and you know, you just don't know what people are going through. They're lonely, they're hurting, and just be that kind word, that light in their lives. Send them an encouraging text, send them a card, like I said on one of my earlier videos, send them a card, a Christmas card, because you just never know what that spoken word, that hug, that, I know it's COVID, but y'all, come on, give people hugs, you know, that was the Lord. He touched people. He touched them and he healed them. And our touch can heal people. And just talking to them. There's so many people who have lost loved ones and spouses and parents. And, you know, it's a hard time of the year for people. Holidays are not easy. We think that a lot of people should be joyful and happy. And it's hard. And I can relate to that, you know, losing my mom. And it's, you know, it just brings back all of those memories of being a kid and spending time with her. And, you know, we had traditions that we used to do. We used to have a day of making just candy and sweets all day and cookies and visiting and Christmas music and, you know, and those times are no more. And I get to do those with James and Bella and Gabe now, and my dad and Linda and my mother-in-law and father-in-law. And, you know, the Lord, thankfully, when he takes away, he gives, and that's a blessing. But just be aware there are people hurting around us. Just be that light. If you know someone who has been through something like you, you can sympathize with them a little bit more, and just be there for them. Just be that encouragement. We know, you know, like I said, I'm in the medical field. James has been in the medical field, and of course he's, you know, a cop now. But this is the time when depression and anxiety, it's just through the roof, because where there's some of those that have just so much joy and so much hope, there's also people on that other spectrum who don't know the Lord, who they're just not ready to reach out to him yet. And we need to be the one taking that to them. And you know, they may not accept us talking about the Lord right now, but you can always say an encouraging word. Send something in the mail to them. Take them by some cookies, peanut butter cookies. You wouldn't believe what a little bundle of cookies would do for a person. You just don't realize that. I talked to my little patients, and just that phone call, I mean, they just, They are so thankful that someone cares. So check on the people around you. Put a smile on. Even when it's hard and we're going through things ourselves, put a smile on, because there's so much more to life, and the Lord has called us to be His light, and we can't go out and be the light if we don't have the joy of the Lord in our heart. Doesn't mean we're always happy. Happiness is temporary. Joy is, the Lord will fill us with His joy even when we're not happy. So y'all go and have a good night and go to church tomorrow. And if you haven't ever been to church, just do it. Just take the step and go, because the Lord will honor you for it. So, all right, y'all. Y'all have a good night. I love you, and I will see you a little later. Bye. Y'all, I'm back again. I know I just finished up showing you the taco soup and how to make it, but I left out some parts, and I'm sure that my mom would be like, what are you doing? That's not right. I did forget to tell you. So after your taco soup is done, about probably 30 minutes before you sit down to eat it, you're supposed to put Velveeta cheese in it. I don't even remember the amount because I don't do it. I have it written down in my cookbook, but you can put as much as you want, dice it up, let it melt in there. It kind of makes it real creamy. And so I know that my mom and my grandma would be saying, you cannot have taco soup without Velveeta. I don't put Velveeta in it. James is not a fan of Velveeta. And so, but we do, when we put it in our bowls, we do some shredded cheese on top, sour cream, if you want to put some guacamole, however you like to dress it is fine, with all your chips and whatever. But I didn't want to leave that part out. Oh, and sour cream, I love sour cream, so I can never forget that. But if you are a big cheese person, which I know a lot of people say that Velveeta is not real cheese, but whatever, those of us who like it, it is cheese to us. You can put it in and let it melt down before you serve it, and it is actually very, very good, and just makes it super creamy. But it is not a have to, if you don't like it, or if you would just rather let people put their own shredded cheese, or they can get their own bowl, dip it out, and put their own Velveeta in it and mix it up. So however they like it. But I didn't want to leave that part out because I knew that some of those who have passed down that recipe to me would say, you're forgetting some things. So I just wanted to get back on and remind you and let you know that it can be fixed several different ways depending on how whoever you're feeding would like it. And so there's a little update, so I hope you try it, hope you enjoy it, and comment below if you have any questions or comments, or just want to, you know, tell me how good or how bad it turned out, because trust me, it may turn out bad and you may not like it. But anyway, so there you go. I will talk to y'all a little later. Love y'all so much. Bye.